the land of crazy hairstyles and overly ridiculous weapons, it's time for the Anime Mavericks Podcast! And now, here they are, your Anime Mavericks!
Hello everyone, and welcome to the Anime Mavericks Podcast, the official anime podcast of RVT! We want to thank you guys once again for joining us here this week. I'm The Shades. Angie? What the hell just happened? Let me check something. This was literally just working before I went live.
Yeah, but can't hear you, Angie.
Are you kidding me? She was just talking a second ago before I hit live!
Yep.
What the hell just happened? Like, I'm not kidding, folks. Literally, just a second ago, before I went live.
All I did was open up Twitch, so I don't know. All I did is try to load up the Twitch page because she said you're going live. Because, like, you heard me 2 seconds before you.
I know,
you said, you're ready, right?
You just saying, like,
my PC sucked. I think I need to get a new one. Like everyone else.
Intro, take two?
Yeah.
Oh, great. Did I just make this not safe for work?
No. When did we ever safe for work, for fuck's sake? Anyway, welcome to the Anime Mavericks Podcast. I'm The Shades.
I'm Yummy Angel.
And I'm Mike Shell.
We are your Anime Mavericks, and we're here to bring you all the anime news, reviews, and interviews that you crave. So aside from that botchy start, how are we doing this week, guys?
Okay, well, I've had a lot of fun since they last saw me. Lots happened.
we've kind of been talking about this Discord, but Angie, yeah, you got married.
Yep. Me and Michael, who used to be the navigator, who I always called Navi. Yes, we got married on November 11th, and then we honeymooned in Disney World, and we finally got to meet you, Shades, and Sean in the real life. It was fun.
That was fun seeing you guys.
Yeah.
So yeah, it's been a crazy couple of weeks for you guys. Oh, month now at this rate.
Yeah.
And then there was Thanksgiving and everything, and yeah, we survived getting back on that Wednesday before Thanksgiving. That was actually pretty smooth. I thought that was going to be a nightmare.
How about yourself, Mike? How you doing?
Doing pretty good. Like I said, enjoyed the month off, but not much too wild happened for me. Other than getting to see you guys again at Ranger Shop, so that was great, and meeting some actors from the WB series at the convention before that, and then pretty good month off, but ready to get back into this.
Amen to that. Not too bad, RN. We got some family issues we got to deal with, some some issues with family health, unfortunately. I'll explain to you guys during our Toonami call later. But for now, everything else is doing fine, doing good, feeling better. So let's have some fun. On tonight's show, it's my pick this week, and I thought we come back with a laugh. You know, let's have some fun to start off our return. So we'll be doing that. And that kind of includes our A and B tonight, though. That one's a little more, well, softer, shall we say. You'll see what I mean when we get there. But first, it is time for everyone's favorite topic. It's the anime news of the week. And starting us off, as always, is our anime informer, Yummy Anji. What do you got for us this week? Anji.
I am pressing the wrong button. I'm holding the alt button instead of the control button on the wrong side of the keyboard.
Oh my god.
It's not my day. It's been a while. This happens when I don't stream for a while, clearly.
Yeah, before we go further, we should mention there's been a lot that's happened in the last month, so we're going to stick to the more recent stuff. But even that alone, good God, so much news. So, Angie, what do you got for us this week?
Okay, so I've got some news from Adult Swim and Crunchyroll because they're partnering with Alcon Entertainment to produce an anime series based on Blade Runner 2049, which is going to be titled Blade Runner Black Lotus, and it's going to have 13 episodes. And the episodes are going to be directed by Shinji Aramaki and Kenji Kamiyama. And, of course, Shinshiro Watanabe is going to be the creative producer on the series. So it's going to be taking place between the first Blade Runner and the sequel. So this looks sort of interesting. And it seems like, why is everything, it's like, you know, Cyberpunk is making a comeback, I guess.
I know, right? Holy crap. But
feels a little late, but
it's going to be interesting here. Now, the question is, like, I think it's safe to assume we're going to probably have some cameos from some of the characters, but it's almost certain we're not going to get any of the actual cast making a vocal cameo. I just don't see Harrison Ford being in this movie. I don't know about you, or being in this series. I don't know about you guys.
No. I'll have to find a lookalike, but it'll be interesting. And it'll be fun. It'll see what, how it, you know, once it actually makes its way over here, how it shakes off with with casting. It'll be interesting. I mean, Shinji Aramaki usually does decent stuff.
Well, it's the guy who made Appleseed, and Kenji Kamiyama did Ghost in the Shell standalone complex. Like, and again, we've got creative producer Shinichiro Watanabe. The guy who did fucking Cowboy Bebop. If there's anyone who could make something like this work, it's fucking Shinichiro Watanabe. Seriously.
They better have a good soundtrack.
Well, that's only if Yoko Kanno's involved. But Yoko Kanno, the worst song.
He likes music, too. I think he's like, when he's not producing anime, he's doing, you know, like, that part, he's doing the music production.
All right, fair enough. Well, maybe we'll have some. We'll be interested to see how this goes. So let's go from new school to old school. Mike Schell, what do you got for us this week?
Hey, Viz Media, you just released the last half of Sailor Moon Super S. When are we gonna get the last part, Sailor Moon Stars?
Oh yes, folks. History is about to be made.
Yeah, thanks for the setup there. But yes, Viz Media is releasing Sailor Moon Stars in spring of next year. So the last season of the original Sailor Moon anime is finally coming out. And, oh boy, it's 34 episodes that we've been waiting for forever.
Yeah, since 1996...
Yeah.
Also, I just realized the joke you were trying to go for, and I feel like a goddamn idiot. You can Dave me later.
But yes, since Viz bought the rights to distribute all of Sailor Moon back in 2014, they've been releasing each season slowly but surely, and this is going to be the last batch of them coming out starting next year.
Yeah.
Good things come to those who wait.
Indeed. Now, here's a little history for you. There's a reason why this particular season of Sailor Moon never got dubbed. And it's because it's a bit risque in terms of its characters. More specifically, the titular Sailor Stars. Because, well, they're guys.
Yeah, their powers somehow involve falling into, I guess, assume a well of, like, the power of some sort of drowned idol or something.
Yeah. They, and as they transform, they basically dress up like they're females. And even Deke and Cloverway were like, there is no way we're ever going to be able to explain this. They had enough trouble with Uranus and Neptune. Do not even let us get into that. But good God. You know, Super S alone was probably a pain in the ass, considering one of their characters was all supposed to be male. Same with Zoe Sight from the original series. There was so many characters they had to fuck with just to make it American friendly. And yes, it sounds as bullshit as it actually was. But this series, there was no way they could get around this particular factoid. So they just said, fuck it, we're never going to do it. But Viz, for you Moonies out there, and I'm sure Easy and Natty and Bishojo White are probably screaming to the heavens, hallelujah, because now that's finally happened. Oh, good God.
And one other slight change on this series as well. That Moonlight Detsetsu that everyone loves for the first four seasons. Yeah, I'm sorry, you're not getting it this season.
No, they made an original theme for Sailor Stars.
Yep.
That was probably a bad idea.
We might have been entering at that point the time where basically, with the revolving pop song for anime, we might have hit. It might have been right around when the transition started. I assume probably around there.
Clearly, but nonetheless, you know, you go on that many seasons with Moonlight Dentetsu, which is still to this day one of the most, like, one of the more iconic theme songs in anime. To change in the last season, bit of a goof. I'm pretty sure the fan base got a little pissed about that one, I'll tell you. I would hate to have seen what if the internet was as prevalent today as it was back in 19... if the internet was prevalent as prevalent in 1996 as it is today, I can only imagine what the freaking social media would have been like back then. Good God. Oh. Good God almighty. Anyway, let's move on from there. Now, for me, for mine, I have not one, not two, but three interconnected stories. And I'm just gonna say this right now. Netflix, what the fuck are you doing? Because we have three major announcements involving Netflix and anime. And they involve three super iconic franchises. Two of them anime, one of them toku. But will be in anime form. Yes, folks, you guys were probably wondering if I was going to bring this up, but how could I not, considering our audience? We're going to have three new announcements from Netflix involving Cowboy Bebop, Evangelion, and Ultraman. Let us begin with the easiest. Evangelion. Because it is they have announced that Evangelion, the original series, and its two movies, Death and Rebirth and End of Evangelion, will be coming to Netflix next spring globally. Now, the big question on everyone's mind right now is, will it be the original dub? Because the announcement does not mention anything about keeping the dub, the ADV dub. And word on the street from very reputable sources, aka the voice actors themselves, are saying that it's most likely going to be redubbed. Which has got a lot of fans freaking the fuck out. Because, say what you will about Shinji Ikari, I don't think anyone else could do it as good as Spike Spencer could. So, we don't know what the reason is, Game Fan. This is just what we know thus far. Again, this is what we're hearing, is that most likely they're going to redub everything. But we don't even know if they're going to bring any of the original cast back. We don't know what their plan is. Though, if the fan base has their way, it will be the original cast, if not keeping the original dub. But again, we know nothing. Netflix has not revealed any information about what they're planning. But nonetheless, we do know that spring 2019 Evangelion will be released globally on Netflix. So we'll have to see. Secondly, let's talk Ultraman. Because it has also been announced that there will be, on April 1st, a new Ultraman anime. Not a toku, nothing live action, an anime. And what's more is, you know all those lovely Ultramen that came after the original, you know, Leo, Taro, Mabius, Ginga, all that stuff. Yeah, go ahead and just wipe that all out of your mind, because this series doesn't involve any of them. In fact, this basically is a sequel to the original Ultraman. This has nothing to do with any of the following Ultraman. It is all about Shin Hayata's son, Shinjiro Hayata. This is kind of interesting on this one. In a way, boys, they're pulling an Ultraman. They've revealed the cast and crew, and again, the release date is going to be on April Fool's Day, which, if this wasn't a global premiere date, that would be a very, very bad idea. But yeah, they're planning on releasing this on April 1st. And they've got a trailer, and this is global, which means we will be getting this. Otherwise, I wouldn't have covered the story. But holy crap. So, we'll have to see how this plays out. Lastly, let's talk Cowboy Bebop, because we have kind of hinted about this in past iterations, but it's finally happening, ladies and gentlemen. We are finally getting a renewed version of Cowboy Bebop in live action. A 10-episode live action series adaptation of the 1998 classic anime series Cowboy Bebop is coming to Netflix. So, and it will be Netflix is handling the physical production. Tomorrow Studios is in a partnership with producer Marty Aldestein, who's done stuff like Prison Break and Team Wolf, and is also being the producer for an upcoming live-action One Piece project. I am not even going to go there. And don't worry, folks. Shinichi no Watanabe, who's also doing the Blade Runner anime, will serve as a consultant for this project. So, so any of you worried about whether or not this is going to be a complete just trashing of the original? No, Watanabe will make sure that doesn't happen. We hope. And Chris Yost, who did the two later Thor movies, The Dark World and Ragnarok, will be writing the first episode and is credited as executive producer. So, we'll have to see.
Yeah, this property in live action is really getting, it's been downgraded to, well, Netflix is pretty good. As long as they don't cancel it.
Yeah. It's been scary because this has been something that's been talked about since like 2013. Sooner than that. Actually, no, it was announced in January of 2009 that they've been working on this project. We've been talking about this since 2009.
Yeah, this is one of the ones that's always on the it's always on the adaptation proverbial back burner. You always hear things about it. It's like oh yeah, they want to do it. Oh, it'll cost too much money. So it'll be interesting to see it on if it actually does come out on Netflix, to see, you know, what we.
Yeah, and here's the scare, and again. Back in when the 2009 talks were going on, this was originally going to star Keanu Reeves as Spike Spiegel. Let that rumble in your head for a little bit. I remember us talking about this. I remember just talking about that, yeah. Keanu fucking Reeves as Spike.
So well, makes me want to say,
I can see... Like I said, seeing Keanu after seeing him as John Wick might not have been such a bad idea at the time then.
Yeah, if we were talking about it today, maybe it wouldn't be such a scary thought, but this was back when the Matrix movies were probably the biggest thing he had done. So,
very true.
Wouldn't it exactly been the greatest of ideas at the time, but nowadays, maybe a little less scary of a thought. But we'll have to see who they get for this new movie, for this new series, if it's going to be good, how well they're going to be able to adapt the stories, and there's so many questions about this. I'm legitimately curious to see how they're going to pull this off. All I'm going to say is, Netflix, don't pull a Death Note!
And get the music right.
Yes, if there is one thing, if there is one aspect of this series that you cannot fuck up, it's the music. It may not be Yoko Kanno, but you've got to capture that feel. Give us a jazzy soundtrack. I think most of us will be okay with that. That's all we ask, because that was what made the series cool, was the smooth, jazzy soundtrack. You play that, you will make this work. Anyway, that is going to do it for us here at the Anime News of the Week this week. I know this one ran a little long, but again, you know, this was just us condensing all of the, you know, so much news happened in anime over the last month. We couldn't begin to cover it all. We had, you know, sad, tragic deaths. We had a new announcement. So much happened. But we just had to go with, you know, just had to act like that didn't happen and just move on to what's recent, what's new. Maybe if we're in a desperate week, we'll talk about some of the stuff. But honestly, with the boom that's going on right now in anime, I don't see that happening for a while. So we'll have to see. But that being said, it's time for anime this week. And it's my pick, actually, this week. So I decided that since we're coming back, let's start off on a fun note and something that's been pretty popular for a while now, but I've never had a chance to see it. I don't know if these guys have had a chance to see it before, but it's one that I just want to kind of see what all the buzz is about. So tonight, we are going to take a look at Konosuba, God's Blessing on This Wonderful World. Oh yes, folks, I'm sure many of you have heard of this series, you've probably seen memes about this series, you've probably seen something about this series here or there, but it's time to finally find out just what the hell this is. And the chat is... you're giving me a good vibe here, chat! The chat's giving me a good vibe here, I like this, a lot. So, let me get the link for you guys here. There you go. I don't know, guys. Think they like it?
Maybe yes. Maybe they're just ready to see what our reaction is to this.
Well, I'm sure that's definitely the case. Again, I am well aware of what this series is capable of. I know enough about this series to know, have an idea of what we're getting ourselves into here. But I want to see what all the hype's about. Again, this is a series that has two seasons already, and I believe there's already a third on the way. So let's have some fun. You guys ready on your end?
Ready here.
All right, then, let's do this. Konosuba, God's Blessing on This Wonderful World, Episode 1. Oh, I can't even get the full... here we go. Episode 1, This Self-Proclaimed Goddess and Reincarnation in Another World. Good God, that's a long-ass title. In 3, 2, 1, play!
Crickets. Attack alert!
My isekai senses are tingling.
Poor guy. Yeah. Is that the booty?
Oh, what is this bright yellow thing in the sky?
the bright light of the day stuff.
Oh. Hey, Yusuke called. He says he'll see you in court. Well, fuck. Blunt much? Wait, what? And the bombshell!
That's the same thing in Yu Yu Hakusho.
It was a tractor!
What happened to him? Huh?
He had a heart attack! He had a fucking heart attack! You know, I kinda can't blame her, but come on! Oh, now you're just being now you're just being a bitch.
Oh, I hope his family sues the hospital.
Wow, now you're just rubbing salt in the wound. Spoil the ending! Oh, wow!
He's a devil king.
Wow. Drama queen much?
Like, is it here or anything?
Well, that's convenient.
I guess it's important to figure out if the auto translate, if the Bible fish translate.
Oh.
Hey, this is the important part of any campaign.
Yeah. Uh-oh, I smell trouble.
Oh.
Oh! Loophole! No one ever said...
She just realized what he said. That was even cuter.
And looks like this was great. This was allowed. You clever bastard! You never said they couldn't pick you!
Hey, healing is important. I probably would have gone with a healing factor.
Seriously. You got played, bitch!
He's not thinking this through, though, probably.
Yeah, karma is a bitch, ain't care.
I think she's better at it.
Poor Aqua did not expect that play.
Kind of looks nice where they are.
Yeah.
Streamers!
Oh, she gonna kill him! She gonna kill him! Okay.
Someone playing an actual video game has probably lost control of his cutscene. Yeah, going right. With the fuck. It's called genre savvy, chicky.
Not a bad idea. Of course not. Thank you. You read my mind.
Ooh, that's a big piece of meat. Good thing Luffy is. Are we sure he didn't get sucked inside his video game?
That's Old Man Joseph! I know that voice!
Yeah, I was just thinking he sounds familiar.
I have expecting that guy to go, "Oh my god!" Kira Crystal, SAO is the quintessential isekai. What the fuck are you talking about? Oh, yeah. You kind of need gold to do anything in this world, you know?
Money. Can't you make money? Probably should have... Don't give them a start.
Oh, she's still on about that shit? Oh, this would be good. Alright. You're gonna bitch up and then I'll see you actually do something. Shut down!
Ooh. Hey, you might want to pretend you're a priestess and not a goddess.
Oh, I think we broke her. I think we broke her.
Yep.
Okay, that's kind of neat, actually.
Yeah, that is. It's a way cooler than using a thumbprint.
Yeah, you're probably asking a lot there. All right, let's see what happens. Low intelligence. Why does that not surprise me?
Just take priest.
Oh, that got their attention.
Well, everyone needs a white mage.
She's beyond just a white mage. She's a freaking white priest.
Yeah, but everyone just started paying attention to her, so.
Pretty much. Ladies and gentlemen, I think we're having a training montage.
Yep.
Oh!
Oh!
Oh! Oh, credits to the dude. The fucker's not... did not need to see that! Well, at least he's fitting in all right.
Oops! She had a little too much.
Puking up rainbows, it looks like.
And more rainbows.
All of a sudden, she's turning into Odoraka.
So when are they gonna leave the starting town, I assume?
That was
someone gonna have to leave. They landed in a sounding town that's just way too peaceful.
This looks like the opening theme. And we see two other characters that we're probably going to be meeting next episode, though we won't be watching that here. Typical J-pop opening, but not bad.
It looks like some point that I get a more different clothes.
I'm going to stop that there since we don't need to see all that. But there we go. Konosuba, God's blessing on this wonderful world. Boy, right at the bat, I can see what all the hype's about. That was actually kind of fun.
It was a cute little first episode.
Yeah, definitely takes the isekai genre and kind of turns it on its ear a little bit.
Yeah, I like the twist of like, oh, I have all these awesome overpowered items, but you're a fucking goddess. I'm taking your ass. Especially since you keep fucking with me. Like, you want to keep picking on me? Fine, bitch, you're coming with me. I love that. That was brilliant. Now, I do know a little bit about what's to come. I haven't watched anything, but I know of the series. And the other two characters, I believe the mage is named Megumi, who is known for having the most powerful spells, but that's all she uses. Even though most of them drain her dry with one spell, she is the epitome of a glass cannon. She'll kill your ass in one shot, but if she misses, she's fucked. But that's where the other party member comes in, Darkness. She is the tank of the group. Not only because she can take a lot of damage, but... and I'm not even kidding here. She gets off on getting her ass kicked. And I don't just mean, you know, and I mean that in the full sense of the term. She gets off on the masochism that she gets. Like, she has a full-on orgasm when she gets her ass kicked. Not even kidding. Yeah, you know what, chat? Yeah. Yeah, I think I'm gonna go ahead and hit that button for you.
Oh my.
So, yeah. That's so you've got the slightly smart but overall average Kazuma. You've got Aqua, who is a great healer, or so she thinks, but I won't get into too much there. That's spoilers. Well, kind of. You've got Megumi, the glass cannon, and you've got Darkness, the masochistic tank. Do the phrase shenanigans will ensue mean anything to you people?
Yeah, definitely shenanigans abound.
I always expect shenanigans to ensue. I forgot.
Ooh, shenanigans. I swear to God, I'll piss up the next person and says shenanigans. Oh.
Fine, just normal hilarity will ensue.
I was making a reference joke there, Angie. You're fine. But seriously, this series, like, this is what we can expect out of the gate. I can see why a lot of people love this series. This is a series that would hook me right in episode one, which, again, for me, it's not exactly hard to do, but it's something that's necessary. Also, I didn't even notice this. USA Flavor, thank you for the follow. Welcome to the madness. I didn't even notice that. We got that 4 minutes ago. But, the voice acting's top-notch. Kazuma sounds appropriate. Aqua sounds very uppity, very cheerful, and yet very whiny. But again, that's kind of how her character's supposed to be. You know, she got dragged into this shit. She's not happy. But, and hopefully the rest of the cast is just as good. So, I don't know about you guys, but I'm hooked. Let's take it to a final vote. Bottom line, would we watch more of this? Angie?
Yes.
Simple but effective. Mike?
Oh, absolutely.
Oh, hell yeah. Like, there's no doubt in my mind I would watch more of this. Like, this is a future anime takeover in some form. I probably will only do one season at a time, but season one of this is now officially on my personal pick list for anime takeover. You can count on that. So definitely, and hopefully you guys feel the same way. We'll set to see from there. But that being said, that's my pick for this week. If you have any suggestions for anime you'd like for us to check out the first episode of here on the Anime Mavericks, link is in the description down below, or you can use the command !AMP. For the suggestion form link to just send in your suggestions there. Remember the rules. Only official websites or YouTube channels will be accepted. No straight comedy, shoujo, or drama anime. 10 to 30 minute episodes only. First episodes only. Unless you have a damn good reason otherwise. And remember to provide a link along with the series title. So that in case your link goes dead. And with that, ladies and gentlemen, it is time for us to switch over and see what's happening over on AMTV. And for today's video, I thought we'd slow things down a little bit with a suggestion from one of our fans. And I think this is a good one. I think this is a fun one. We're going to take a classic 80s song, 1980s song, hitting that new wave trip, and kind of play it up a little bit here. We'll see what I mean. It's going to get a little soft, shall we say. And you'll see what I mean here shortly as we check out today's video here on AMTV.